10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
The Litefoot Show.
It was all a dream.
One for the treble, two for the bass. Litefoot.
Y'all know we run the town.
Litefoot.
Y'all know we run the town.
Litefoot.
Y'all know we run the town.
The Litefoot Show.
Well, hello everyone, and welcome to episode 21 of the
Lightfoot show. Hello.
Look at how synced up that was. We want to say again, thank you to everybody that's out there. I want to make sure to get this in there that if you have not sent in a comment or a suggestion and you'd like to, you can do it at show@lightfoot.com.
Yeah.
We, of course, appreciate those. Want to make sure again that you spell Litefoot, L-I-T-E-F-O-O-T. So that it doesn't end up in the cyber bliss, or not bliss, but the cyber...
Space.
Yeah, cyberspace. Unclaimed, because I will not get it. L-I-T-E-F-O-O-T. My social media is at Litefoot, and the beautiful Carmen...
Carmen Davis.
Yes. Is at iCarmen Davis, so please follow her, like her page.
Yes.
Facebook, Instagram, the Gram... Mm-hmm.
Snapchat.
And then I can be found at, I think it's The Litefoot, right, on Snapchat?
I don't know.
I snap every once in a while. Be sure to go ahead and what do you do? Follow, snap? What do you do on that?
Yeah,
you just follow?
Yeah, you follow.
Follow?
Yeah, follow. Right. See, you know, we're getting you up there. Yeah, getting you up to speed.
You know, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram... I'm there. Snap.
We gotta work on it.
Hang out. I'll come through. I'm gonna shoot through every once in a while.
Room to improve.
So this is episode 21. We want to thank Native Style Clothing,
yes,
the great, amazing, wonderful, hospitable people over there at Native Style Clothing. be sure to go by nativestyleclothing.com. Sign up to the email.
Yeah.
You can do that there.
Getting ready to launch a few more products as well.
Launch some more products, kids' clothes.
Excited.
And children in general.
Yeah.
Some new women's clothes,
yep,
I believe.
We've been working really hard on the designs.
Those great people over there at Native Style Clothing. Gotta love them. And of course, Litefoot.com. And, you know, we are in the holiday season.
Yeah.
We're officially in the Christmas window.
Yeah.
Thanksgiving just passed.
Yep.
I don't think anybody gorged themselves too bad this year at our house.
I don't think so. It was good food, though. I just tried not to, you know, go overboard.
I think,
gotta maintain.
Plenty of food there.
Yeah.
Great. Had family.
Yes.
It was great.
Yep.
I don't even know if this is a topic. I'm just kind of going with it because, you know, I went into the holiday thing you know, of course... We need to buy native and support native, so support our native business.
Yes.
How about that?
Yeah.
Litefoot.com/store and nativestyleclothing.com. That's enough about that. So, yeah, there you go. I was like, wow, it sounds like there's ongoing thunder right here. And it's the pop screen hitting the mic. There's our technical difficulty for this show. Got it all the way early.
Yeah.
We hope you guys are doing great out there. And we want to say thank you for the likes. Thank you for the comments.
Yes, absolutely.
Got a lot of feedback about the whole Pocahontas thing that Nicki Minaj did. And then, lo and behold, our commander...
Not even a week later.
Commander-in-chief decided to go bring it right back to the forefront with some remarks.
Right.
But we'll get into that in a minute. Just want to say thank you again. Thank you for all the support. Thank you for everything out there. And again, hope your holidays are off to a great start.
Yeah.
Okay. Where are we going? Take me down the road.
You kind of went down the road.
21.
First.
This is episode 21.
Yeah.
21. Our son's in the studio, and I'm sure he's probably going, oh my God, Dad, really? Are you really saying 21?
We keep telling him that we're like the cool parents, but he, you know.
Well, we are the cool parents.
We are the cool parents, but he just.
Are you kidding me?
I don't think he realizes.
I'm going to go have him hang out with some other parents and see if we're cool or not.
Yeah.
We can come back. God, Dad, those guys are really lame. You guys are so cool. Okay, anyway. Go ahead.
Well, you actually kind of, I was going to talk about the long holiday weekend. You kind of already like just summarized
it. I felt like I didn't know whether to go or stop, or it was getting dark here early. Had some extra days hanging out there.
Yeah.
And as tough as I've been running, I felt like there was something I was supposed to be doing.
Right, right.
I felt like I should be someplace. I was, you know, not handling my business. I was late. I was like, I felt irresponsible.
You slept in. You watched football.
Whew.
We got a Christmas tree.
The Seahawks barely beat the worst team in the NFL. Know,
that was bad.
Whew. Thank you, Seahawks, for making that such a struggle.
That was really bad.
The teams that were getting ready to play probably would have whipped them. Like, you know, they probably would have had to call the game.
It's going
to
be a tough.
No disrespect to any 40 Winers fans out there, but it was a tough game.
It was tough.
Tough to watch, and then we lost more people.
We did.
It's just one of those years.
It is. You know, you have off years, right? So this is their off year.
Yeah, man. Like, the whole team's like
injured.
Injured. Yeah. We might have to, like.
We're still fans.
We might have to forfeit the rest of the season if we lose any more people.
We're still fans.
Yeah, we are fans. Seahawks for life. Yeah. Anyway. So football.
Football. Got a Christmas tree.
We did. I think this may be, you know, I know you were saying that there may have been years. I don't remember them. I don't remember any years in my recent memory where we had a real Christmas tree, because usually we just like go in the garage and like, it's amazing how fresh this tree has stayed after 5 years.
Yeah.
And set it up and then do that deal. But it's a little bit more laborious.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little bit more complicated, a little bit more challenged to pull it out, separate all the leaves, you know, do this whole deal. And not that crazy, but it just adds to the process. I felt like the tree went up like really quick.
Well, I think too. Well, part of it is to actually going to get a tree and the act of, you know, just
which I thought was really, you know, because our little guys have never had a real tree,
right? And so that was really cool. We went to this tree farm and they got to see reindeer.
Are people upset that you go get a real tree? Is that like a bad thing?
I don't know.
They're probably like, you tree killers. Is there anybody that's mad at that?
I think so. Some people, but I mean,
can't replant it, right?
Well, but we have.
Maybe we could burn it for firewood.
No, I think. I mean, for the past how long have we had a fake tree? So
yeah. So okay, well, we got credit. Right. So
it was just a nice experience, right, for the kids.
I don't think this was probably on the list of things: real versus fake, and the controversy over buying a real Christmas tree. This may not be on the topic.
No, it was not on the topic, but you know.
But it is. It's awesome.
Yeah. And they got to see reindeer. There was reindeer, and they were asking, you know,
and
how
Sequoia
come
was like completely not thinking that it was a real reindeer. Like,
right.
Why are they not in the North Pole? And what is Santa going to do? I mean, he's very concerned.
That's so right. We kind of had to, you know, we were on our toes, right?
Yeah. And then there was a camel there.
Yeah. Moses. Named Moses.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
So.
And they were feeding him carrots, apparently. Because our little guy was pretty, the other little guy was pretty amazed that the camel was eating carrots.
Yeah.
Okay. Or was it the reindeer eating carrots?
No, it was the reindeer.
Oh, okay. Well, somebody was eating a carrot.
Were you there?
I was putting the tree on the car while you guys were off frolicking in the activities.
It was
Daddy
nice.
Was doing the work. Daddy was tying down the tree so it didn't fly off the car while you guys were back there going, oh, look at the reindeer.
No, it was a
I
nice.
I came in on the end of the family photo, didn't even make it into that.
The sleigh, we got in the little sleigh.
Yeah, I got punked on the whole deal. No, but I mean, it was, we actually, you know, I'm such, you know, for one, I'm kind of a Christmas geek.
Yeah.
I am. You know, like my favorite color, you know,
Christmas red,
but mm-hmm. You know, I think it's a pretty special time of year.
Yeah.
Not about the materialism stuff, but probably more about the family, about the smells of the season, and the all that kind of stuff. And probably, I guess it's one of the childhood memories that I hold on to.
Sure.
Because it was kind of a tumultuous time there, sort of at a window of it. So I mean, having that special time was pretty key in my childhood. And so I'm, you know, so jump forward. Okay. We're getting the one tree, the main tree, right?
Uh-huh.
I hate the fact that I'm even saying we have a main tree, like the centerpiece tree.
Mm-hmm.
The little guys are walking by. They go, oh my God, look at that tree. I like daddy. I like that. And I'm like, oh, God,
he's a sucker. He was a sucker.
So I know we have a sort of a TV room, mm-hmm. media room And I was, yeah, well, you know what? We could put, and you know, good God, we have enough decorations.
Yeah, we have more decorations.
To probably, you know, I mean, it's all, look at these lights do this and those lights do that. And so it's not like we're short on
right.
on the tools
right.
to get it done. And so I was like, okay, it's not that much, you know, wasn't that big of a dent in the pocketbook. And so I was like, okay, we'll get this one too. So while you guys were back there, I was loading up the smaller tree on top of the roof. And then, by God, that was my Oklahoma thing for this episode. We go to Target because I realized we didn't have enough of the one kind of
you
light.
You have to have a special, the same kind of light.
Of course.
Yeah.
So we go to Target, and I'm there, mm-hmm. and the other two boys didn't want to go, so we brought the littlest guy. And Quinn, get in there. And they have these like little tinsel trees,
and
little
they
small,
look,
two and a half.
I mean,
they look cheap.
They look cheap.
And yet he saw it was shiny, and he was like, "Dad, I gotta have that tree. That's so cool, Dad."
So
and I'm like sitting there going,
"But
we already have the second tree. Now we're looking at the third tree," and I'm like, "Man, I can't do it," you know. And then there's a guy standing there looking at lights.
Yeah.
And he's watching Quinn just play me. He's watching him literally just put me together, size me up, and he's like, "Oh, Dad, that's so cool. That's so cool. Look at how pretty it is. Look how nice it is." And I'm like, "Ah, okay." It was like $5.
Yeah.
It's $5. So where they get you, though, is you're not just going to – right in front of all the trees, they have all these little baby Christmas ornaments for the tree.
Yep.
So they got me for another $5, too. So I got out of there.
Sucker.
That's that whole, isn't there like a meme about I went to Target to get
yes.
soap and I ended up buying yes. $200 worth of stuff?
Yeah. You're a sucker for it, though.
Yeah. But the guy was like, "You know what? Hey, look, it's that time of the year. $5, you know, little extra $5. What's it going to, you know, big deal." So now the boys have a fake gaudy Christmas tree in their room. And we have the other ones. We have Christmas trees in every room of the house, basically. No, I'm just kidding. We don't.
No. We're not going to
do that.
But
tis the season.
Yeah.
Tis the season. And why not?
And we did cookies.
And let me say, you know, here's another reason. How many years were we celebrating Christmas in a hotel?
Right.
Or on the tour bus?
Right.
And, I mean, wah, right? I mean, you know, people are like, "Oh, poor you." But
no,
it wasn't really Christmas. We had
were away
one of these,
from home.
We had one of these little 2-foot Christmas trees.
Yeah.
And our oldest boy would literally get out of his bunk and go in the front of the bus and go like, "How did Santa get in here? This locks up pretty tight.
Yeah.
How did Santa get in the bus?" And we had Christmas, you know, we were grateful. We were thankful.
Yep.
And again, I'm not complaining. I'm not saying, "Oh, wow, poor us."
But
we
now
weren't
you're,
home. We
right.
weren't home.
And now we've been
we were
able
not
to home.
Be home. For so many years.
Yeah.
We were grinding from one
yep.
event to the next, doing it, making it happen, just on a mission. And we just didn't have that.
Right.
So now that I am.
Yeah. We kind of went overboard.
Making up. Making it up.
Getting it in. Getting
making
it in.
Up.
But you
making
know.
It up.
It's all good.
Last night we went to the little Christmas parade.
Yeah. We did Christmas cookies and
did Christmas cookies the night we did the tree.
Yeah.
Or no.
The night before. The night before.
Oh, we're done.
Yeah.
We're done. We don't have to do anything else until Santa comes and gives me a gift. Santa's going to come give me a gift?
Yeah.
Probably, I would hope. We'll see.
But you've been good.
Yeah, I have been good.
Yep.
What else?
So, let's get right into it. Let's get into...
trying to turn my coffee cup so people can't see the brand.
Let's get into what happened with...
With what?
President Trump and...
Presidente.
you know,
it was such an easy, teed up, you know... Almost anybody could have, you as somebody that's in the limelight or somebody that has a platform or somebody that has, you know, you kind of just, sometimes it's harder, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I've been in those situations where I'm hosting things or I'm sort of out there and, you know, you're like, "Oh my gosh, how am I going to bridge what just happened into the next thing?" Or, "Wow, this is kind of a controversial thing," or "I'm having to present this or this topic," or "I got to talk about this," or, you know, "We got to address this issue." This wasn't any of that.
No.
This was a no-brainer. This was a softball.
Yeah.
This was you can just knock it out of the park. It has an opportunity to just be a really great moment, a feel-good moment for the country, honoring Navajo code talkers.
Which, I mean, they did so much for this country,
and,
right?
And shout out to all the other tribes. There's other tribes that were code talkers.
Right.
So not to disrespect or take anything away from all of our great Navajo code talkers. Obviously, there was probably more, maybe, allegedly. I don't know. Technically, potentially. But there was also, I want to say, Choctaw.
I think Choctaw, Pawnee was...
Other tribes.
Yeah.
We'll just say other tribes. Yeah. And so shout out and respect to all of them who did something that otherwise we
absolutely
potentially could have had the war go a different way.
Right.
So
right.
Here's the moment. And you do it and mess it up. You mess it up by taking shots at somebody who has claimed Native American ancestry. You know, the jury's out on that whole deal, whether that's, you know, real. I know that on The View, apparently today they were talking about whether she did or she wasn't, and she got into law school or Harvard
or
whatever.
But I mean, it's like beyond that though, right? It's not even about her. It's the fact, it's the reference, and to disrespect elders like that, like why would, just like what you said, like why would you even reach for that? Why would you do that? And in front of that Andrew Jackson portrait?
Well, I was going to get to that in a minute, because that's a whole other... That's levels. This is levels, right?
Right.
This is a whole other level.
Right.
The Andrew Jackson thing.
Right.
But Pocahontas, who unwillingly... I mean, you know, look, none of us lived then, right? Mm-hmm. We don't know technically what happened, but we know enough to know that... This wasn't a situation somebody went into willingly, willfully, and helped these people or did these things and went through what she went through. And then ultimately, from what I understand, and maybe I'm wrong, if, you know, email me if I am, was ultimately poisoned, right? Lost her life because of all of this turmoil. And we've got her memory, her legacy that we're left with. And... you know, Disney turned it into an animated movie, made it seem like this was an incredible love story.
Right. Totally. Just,
you know, Disney fight it.
Yeah.
Right. And since then we have not, respected the contributions of this person, in America to, you know, what she contributed in helping, advance, what we know today as the United States. It's hard for me to think about all these things and kind of go, are we advancing or was that an advancement or not? But anyway, she did what she did and here we are. And to then take this person's whole legacy in life and turn it into a word derogatorily used to belittle somebody else denigrates her whole existence.
Right.
And denigrates... ultimately, the Native American struggle. I think
absolutely.
She becomes an embodiment, a personification
absolutely.
Of the Native American struggle and how it just is wiped away. It's desensitized. It's removed. I don't see any difference between that and the desensitization of headdresses, mascots, anything else that have meaning, that has an applicability still to today to our people or to society, and it's diminished.
Yep.
It's demeaned, and people just, oh, what's the big deal?
Right.
So what? Who cares? This is akin to all of those other things, and to take a moment where you're standing with, I don't know how many exactly Navajo code talkers that are left, but there aren't very many, and there were three.
Right.
Standing there in the Oval Office, and I believe, I could be wrong, President Begay of the Navajo Nation was near. I want to say he was close.
I'm not
may
sure.
have been in the Oval Office. Yeah. I know staff was, it was sort of a last minute thing, I think, and folks were trying to get in there. But at least key officials from the Navajo Nation were close by.
Right.
And I don't even know how appalling it was to watch this person blow such a moment that should have been a softball.
Right.
It should have been easy. It, you know, veterans everywhere, military folks should have been all honored by the sacrifice and the service of these gentlemen and all like them in Indian country. And keep in mind, Indian people, Native Americans, serve, Alaska Natives, serve at a higher per capita than any other race of people in this country, always have, still holds true to this day. So why would you take a second away from them to turn it on to some other attention? You know, it's just
very
like,
deliberate. I mean, people want to say, oh, he's just stupid. He's just an idiot. It was very deliberate.
Was it?
I think there's other
stuff that was, could have been. I would hope not. I know that there's a big, thing going on at the CFPB. She's obviously the sort of the architect of the CFPB, the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, who has, again, been an agency that's overreached and gone after Indian tribes for, their economic development pursuits. Mm-hmm. And she has been, and then that's what gets me, is that here she's the architect of it, and she does nothing to stop this federal agency from going after Indian tribes that are trying to better their communities and push forward. So it's kind of like people pick and choose when they want to talk about the Indian thing, right?
Sure.
But I don't, I could see how it could be intentional.
I think any reason to minimize, to me, I was very sensitive of how, he was, you guys, it's like when you say you people, air quotes, you people or your people, it just kind of is like, that throws me off right off the bat, and he was like, you guys are a special group of people.
And I think, I can't remember the exact segue, how he got into it, but it was something along
that,
the lines.
That we've been here longer than anyone else.
Right. Okay. So that was great. I mean, keep going with that. But then he goes and we have another person that claims to be Native who's been here also forever.
Right. and it was just so, a jab at her.
But notice this. He takes a jab at demean. He immediately stands it up and then tears the whole we've been here forever thing.
Yeah.
He immediately lessens it.
Exactly.
By rolling it over into. So I saw somebody say something today that he was playing to his base, that he's always playing to his base. He never forgets who his key audience is. And so I guess I can see how, I just think some of these things, a lot of these times, he goes off script, he says whatever comes into his head.
Yeah.
In his brain, out his mouth. And I kind of felt like he just couldn't resist the moment. I mean, he's talking about Native Americans, Pocahontas is this this thing he uses to sort of go at Warren, Senator Warren, and it just kind of came out his mouth, right? Okay. It's just Trump being Trump. Right. I mean, you can't be too upset about it if you don't have very high expectations of, where the bar is going to get raised. So I kind of felt like that. But here again, to your point earlier, Obama had taken out the portrait of Andrew Jackson out of the Oval Office. People may not know this.
Puts it back in.
He, within the first few days of him being in office, finds the portrait. Puts it back in the Oval Office. Now, why is that important? People may not even be clued into what the big deal about. Okay, Andrew Jackson, he's on the $20 bill. President, I think he may have been the only president that ever balanced the budget, ever, in the history of the United States. Okay, so I'm not saying 99.99. Maybe he's 99%. The worst president to Native Americans ever. He we'll give him some credit for doing like those couple things.
Yeah.
But outside of that,
he was the worst.
He is the architect for the Cherokee Nation's removal, attempted decimation, many other tribes,
many
Indian
other tribes.
Policies in this country. He was known as the Indian killer. This was not a friend.
No.
In any way to the death of him was not a friend of Indian country.
Right.
And even all of that, there was a, I want to say it was a Creek gentleman, maybe Choctaw, I can't remember. definitely wasn't Cherokee, that saved his life in a battle.
I didn't know that.
Shot the guy that was going to shoot him. I got to remember the battle, but anyway, now flashback to us in the Oval Office or them in the Oval Office and seeing this all play out underneath. I mean, the Oval Office has many different sections of wall, mm-hmm. many different sections of where you mm-hmm. could have done this honoring. It is chosen. Okay. Yeah, and I got to say, not a whole lot is just arbitrarily done. When people know it's going to be on live television, you're yeah. taking a moment to put it on the news, to put it on television, and you're not intentionally going, where are we going to do this?
It's deliberate.
It cannot not be yeah. deliberate
yeah.
that you're going to honor these folks underneath the portrait of the person that was really the eradicator, the exterminator of Native Americans in this country.
Right.
It didn't get lost on me.
No.
I had folks calling me, texting me, did you see the picture of Andrew Jackson in the back? Did you see that? Maybe most Americans don't know this, right? I wouldn't right. doubt that one bit.
Right. I wouldn't either.
But for people that know, there's probably maybe there's Native people out there that don't know. But this is the person that Adolf Hitler based Mein Kampf. Mm-hmm. He referenced Andrew Jackson and his extermination policies to create Hitler's extermination policies
right.
in Mein Kampf.
Right.
This is the guy.
Yeah.
This is the guy that gave Hitler the playbook. Probably Americans don't know that. How many people don't know that there was this genocidal rage here? Mm-hmm. We talk about Black Lives Matter. We talk about other lives matter. Man, we've been having the Native American Lives Matter campaign for centuries here.
Right.
Right?
And it's always, I mean, it always
on deaf ears.
Correct. Because it's basically the invisible plight.
And that's what gets me when I'm watching these talk shows and people are like, well, you know, can we really hold that against Senator Warren? Because
maybe her people said that she was Native American.
And, you know, and when we grew up, they told us we were Native American.
Right.
And, you know, they told us. And I did Ancestry.com.
And I was 7% Native American.
And so I was like, see, I am an Indian. Now, I think it's important. And I think that ultimately for us to get there with our issues, it absolutely has to grow out of Indian
yeah,
country.
Yeah, definitely.
It just like the civil rights movement took on a whole nother tone.
Absolutely.
When other communities got involved and made it a bigger issue, it started affecting the vote. It started affecting
absolutely.
More people. And so more people were engaged. And then it became a real thing when people could get unelected or put out of
yeah.
office, because now people outside of the African American community were saying, this is not right.
Right.
We need that.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have that.
No, we don't have that.
I'm
not making light of people that, you know, do feel like they're Native American or,
no, but be it at least 4 days of the week.
What, exactly. That stand up for the issues, understand, learn,
when we have something come
the
up,
history.
When we have something come up.
Right.
Be with us.
Yeah.
Don't just go, oh, well, that's their thing.
Right.
I mean, everybody expects us to be down with it and respect it whenever other
yep.
communities say this is what the issue is. Okay, well, cool. If you say it's the issue, it's the issue.
Right.
Well, when we say it, what about it?
Right.
I mean, I just saw T.I. Put out more stuff
yeah.
with headdresses and demeaning. I mean, really, bruh, you're doing the same thing Trump's doing.
Yeah.
You're demeaning and desensitizing a whole group of people to the vital beauty of our culture that we
yeah.
need to hold on to.
Yeah.
And you're doing it, man. You can say you're not doing it. You can say whatever. You can talk about how it ain't you. And that's not. But you are doing the same thing to us that you complain about other folks doing to you. There it is. You cannot like it. You cannot want to hear it. But it is what it is. If you don't
right.
like it done to you, don't do it to other people.
Right.
You know, I mean, there's people in our own community that are probably going, oh, my God, you know, don't say that to T.I. might not like us. I don't care. Who cares?
Right.
It's the truth. You want respect, give respect. You don't give respect, you don't get respect. It is. It's as simple as that. It is what it is, man. I mean, I'm sorry for getting a little heated about
no,
it.
No, I agree. I mean, it's just
you got to call it on.
Very,
sometimes you got to call it.
I just feel like it's just unfortunate. It breaks my heart to, you know, and especially to see our elders up there and to have someone say those things. It's just, you know, it's frustrating. Absolutely.
Think about what's playing in their mind.
Right.
Maybe every single one of those gentlemen have in their mind still to this day being on the battlefield, doing whatever they had to do to survive. And you get to the moment where you're finally in the Oval Office being recognized. And I'm not saying that they haven't been recognized by maybe past presidents or other folks. Mm-hmm. But here's this moment.
Yeah.
And you're thinking maybe you almost met death.
Mm-hmm.
You were able to survive and come back to your family.
Right.
You've been able to live, you know, a long life. And here's your moment to be honored on national television. And this guy disrespects the whole damn thing.
Right.
And you got to sit there and think to yourself, what's playing in their mind? What are they thinking about?
Right.
As this is happening. And so, yeah, absolutely, it's disrespectful.
Yeah. No, it breaks my heart.
And I know President Begay is going to be on, Navajo Nation President Begay is going to be on, I think, Anderson Cooper tonight.
Yeah.
Or was on Anderson Cooper, because I know this is going to come out here in a minute. And by the time that this comes out, he may have already been on television. I think he's already been on another program. Hey, more power to you, Mr. President Begay.
Yeah.
Let him know. Let him know, man.
The president.
Let him know. Let him know. I mean, you got to change it. We got to change the narrative. It's not okay.
It's not okay. And that's the thing. I mean, as long as we allow it and accept it and not use our voice to say it's wrong, it's going to keep happening.
That's right.
And you're, you know, and it's like exactly true with, you know, that is why that we can't allow Nicki Minaj to do stuff like she did last week with the Pocahontas.
Now, again, and allegedly.
Allegedly.
She didn't draw it.
She didn't draw it, but she posted it.
Right.
And so which she endorses it. Right?
Allegedly. But if she didn't endorse it,
well, if someone else posted it for her, then, you know, that's their bad. But
yeah, you need to fire your staff.
I mean, but it's the same thing with, like, what you're saying. Like, you know, people say, oh, this TI thing isn't a big deal. Oh, the mascot issue isn't a big deal. It is a big deal.
It is a big deal.
Because this is ultimately.
And it's just been in the last couple years that finally some national organizations got the wherewithal to come through and stand up against that.
Yeah,
because I know when I was talking about it, when I first came out, you know, we were, it was very few people.
Yeah.
And we mostly caught it for speaking out about it. Mm-hmm. And I remember I was like called militant and an activist for standing up against people using, you know, disrespectful, cartoonish images of our people. Because here's what happens. It's just the same thing that was done today with the Pocahontas thing.
Yeah.
When people diminish who you are and they desensitize important, you know, parameters of everything that makes you who you are, people can't take you seriously.
Right.
And when Absolutely. People have lost respect and the perception has become buffoonery or cartoonish, then people attribute that to how they look at you.
Right.
And it does, absolutely. If it doesn't, then you tell me how come we can't seem to get very much frigging done in this country. How come we can't get our tax
dual taxation,
and we're weighing in on what Congress should do in the new tax bill that's coming out? None of it's in there. Literally, folks, none of it made it into the tax bill. None of it. So, I mean, I come from that place, you know, being in business. When people tell you how they feel about you, when they think about you, mm-hmm. believe them.
Mm-hmm.
They ain't confused.
Right.
They're telling you how they think about you. And you're going to go back in there and go, oh, well, could you please reconsider? No, they ain't going to do that. We don't have leverage.
Yeah.
We don't have leverage. And until we get leverage, we ain't going to have anybody hear us. Right. So, you know, we stand for something, fall for anything.
Yeah.
This is the Litefoot Show. It's a family-oriented, very laid-back. But you come over here kicking some dirt and kicking some rocks, and we'll flip it on you in about a half a second. You know, it's real on this side. Yeah. Man. These are real deal struggles.
Absolutely.
And people are out there in the community suffering, you know, with a whole variety of things that people are going mm-hmm. through. And I want to say, you know, we got to do something about it. And some of us been trying to do something about it, but everybody's got to get together with it. So as much as we're trying to talk to other communities about, hey, man, pay attention, do this, you know, think about this when you do this and blah, 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 blah. We got to think about what we do.
Right.
Clean up our own house first.
Yeah.
It ain't everybody else's job. It's our job too, right? Everybody loves to talk about it when it's oil or when it's, you know, the earth or or some of these other, like, you know, easy sort of quote unquote easy to engage. And I don't feel like this is something that we can all connect on. But where are they when it's like opioids?
Right.
Where's everybody at? Where's the big, you know, rally and everybody coming from around the world and the press and the media for, you know, the epidemic that's going on? You know, what about healthcare?
Yeah.
What about the food that people are eating out there on the res? What about all that?
Right.
Yeah. I don't see those folks.
I don't see them either.
You know, how many people that was at Standing Rock that was out there that wasn't Native are coming through communities all the time still trying to give assistance or help or do anything? How many? Y'all better wake up, man.
But I think, and that's where you're saying, is that we have to do something, not wait for somebody else. We have to do it, and we have to realize.
Ain't nobody coming for us.
Exactly.
Nobody coming for you.
Nobody's coming to save you.
I'm just glad that I realized that a long time ago.
Yeah.
Wasn't nobody coming for me, man.
Right.
Wasn't nobody coming for me. And we wake up every single day knowing that if we don't do it, it ain't going to get done.
Absolutely.
So we don't depend on anybody else. We depend on ourselves. But we got to get back to being sovereign individuals. The sovereignty has to become personalized.
I agree.
It has to become individualized, and then it'll mean something. Yep. Because if we want
wellness in our communities, you know, I mean, that starts with yourself, right? And you have to focus on making yourself well so that you can teach wellness to other people and to your kids.
Don't talk about it unless you're about ready to be about it.
I agree.
So glad we fixed that one. Whew. Hey, man, just, you know, everybody, nobody's perfect. Let's just... Nobody's perfect. We're broken by nature. We're never going to be ever perfect, any of us. We're humans, right? And I think all we can do is try our very best to be respectful and to be compassionate to other people. And beautiful things happen when that goes down. You know, when it's rooted in love and thinking about other people. I mean, we've talked about it even in our own marriage. It's about, you know, how are you doing? What's up with you? And if you're thinking about, well, what's up with you? How am I doing? Then it all seems to work.
Yeah.
But when I'm worried about me, you're worried about me, somebody's going to come up on the short end of the stick.
Right.
And I think when, as communities, we're concerned about how the other community is doing, and we stop all these divisive, separatist sort of positions that people take.
Mm-hmm.
It's easy to do that. It's hard to build bridges.
Yeah.
It's easy to build walls, hard to build bridges.
Yeah.
You got anything else you want to say?
Just listen to you.
No, I mean, I don't want, I think you got a lot to say too. I mean, I know, because when we're talking about this, I know you've got very strong opinions and, you know, you feel.
No, I feel the same way. I mean, I just, you know, like I said, it just is, it's one of those things where, when something like that happens, you just feel like you just got smacked in the mouth. Like, you know, someone just socked you.
Well,
and you know, I just feel that it does break my heart. But after that, it's, you know, you have to turn that pain and that anger into being productive
and constructive
And that's the part that I think, you know, it's easy to feel hurt. I think everybody feels, you know, it kind of just hits you in that place where it's like, you know, damn. And you just, and as a woman, you know, it absolutely is heartbreaking just time and again. But that's where it's easy to stay within that pain and that anger part of it and just kind of be mad for no reason, right? But it's like the answer is really to be a productive person in society and to change those things. And that's where, you know, it starts with yourself.
Preach.
So...
And it is, you know, because individually it feels that way.
Right.
But where I've always felt, you know, I mean, let somebody say whatever to me, you know, I mean, whatever, bro. You know, I've been having people run their mouth and, you know, I've been in the public eye for the majority of my life.
Yeah.
So I've been having people take shots at me.
Right.
but say something about my son. Say something about my family. Say something about my...
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
No, I know. I know.
I'm just saying. You know, and I guess why I thought about that is because I was watching this be done to some elders and some Native people that didn't deserve that. And that's what kind of got me.
You're going to make me cry. I agree.
That's why this show is a little different today, because right. I mean, it's pretty fresh. Yeah. And that ain't okay, man. And so we're going to get to anything else?
I think, well.
So this is another one of them episodes where we got to go pick up our kid.
That's that real. Sounds we like do. So, it sounds that like, is so
well,
real.
Well, can't you like start the show earlier? Like, man, we ran over here to do the show because there's so much going on. But I mean, this is so important that we engage and we connect and that we, you know, to continue to try to do our part to inspire and motivate and get people thinking and, you know, and do that.
Yeah.
You know, right? I mean, well, I've listened to people today all day long talk about what they think, and then they're never going to be on a reservation. And they can talk about their I thought I was this and I got my ancestry.com. Okay, well, great. Hope to see you on the battlefield.
Right.
Hope to see you out there on the court, but probably ain't going to be out there on the field. Yeah. You're going to be standing up in the stands. Maybe you don't even come to the game. So good for you, but doesn't mean anything. And until somebody stops talking about it and starts doing something about it. So it's a little bit different show today.
It is. It's a little bit heavier.
But it's heavy. It's heavy. You can't make light of that.
Right? No, you can't. Not at all. Not at all.
You can't make light of it even on the Litefoot show. And that's what it is. So y'all don't know this because there ain't a camera under the table, but Karma's been popping me in the knee for like
I just don't want to be late for two minutes.
So yeah, we got to go get him because we're not about to leave him standing out literally out in the rain at the bus stop with nobody there to pick him up. So, you know, hey, look, man, be compassionate. Do your best to be the best person you can be. Don't be afraid to, you know, speak up about these issues. And
right. Use your voice. You have a voice.
Appreciate you all. Thank you. Thank you for your support of us.
Yes.
You know, if you disagreed with something we said today,
email us. We'll talk about it.
Put an email together and shoot it over. And we'll make sure and address it on the next episode.
Yes.
And thank you. Thank you for all the support. Again, Litefoot.com/store, NativeStyleClothing.com. It's Christmas by Native.
Yes.
This is
the Litefoot Show.
No, that's not you.
Oh.
I said this is
Carmen Davis.
And where can they find you?
I Carmen Davis.
At I Carmen Davis. And I am, I guess, the Litefoot Show in a way. But at Litefoot, thank you so much for your support. Thank you for tuning in. Subscribe, youtube.com/Litefoot. Subscribe to the podcast.
Yes.
Wherever you get your podcast as well. So thank you so much. We appreciate you. And until the next time, this has been the
Litefoot Show. Okay.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. The Litefoot Show. It was all a dream. 1 for the treble, 2 for the bass. But the Litefoot.
Y'all know we run the town.
Litefoot.
Y'all know we run the town.
Litefoot.
Y'all know we run the town.
The Litefoot Show.